हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, एएस लेवल केमिस्ट्री चैप्टर इज एटॉमिक स्ट्रक्चर, लेक्चर नंबर 13। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू योर एएस लेवल एग्जामिनेशन। नाउ दीज क्वेश्चंस आर कॉमनली आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम्स एंड यू कैन फाइंड दिस स्टाइल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इन योर पास्ट ईयर पेपर्स। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू स्केचिंग ऑफ अ ग्राफ एंड दिस ग्राफ इज स्केच्ड फॉर आयोनाइजेशन एनर्जी वैल्यूज versus electrons removed from a given element. The element that I have chosen, it is sodium. Now, what information you know about sodium? The atomic number of sodium, it is 11. So what will be the electronic configuration of sodium? Electronic configuration of sodium is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1. This is the atomic number and this is the electronic configuration of sodium. Now, if you look at the atomic number, one thing you can guess quite easily that how many ionization energy values are possible for sodium. Sodium can have 11 ionization energy values. Why? Because ionization energy is the energy related to remove an electron, energy related to lose an electron. And sodium, one sodium, it can lose how many electron? One sodium atom, it can lose all the electrons. No doubt, during bond formation, sodium loses only valence electron. But we are talking about generally, if enough energy is available, a given material can lose all the available electrons. So sodium can remove 11 electrons, sodium can lose 11 electrons. That is why sodium can have 11 values for ionization energy. Second thing. Now, what is the sequence of removal of electrons? Sodium is going to remove 11 electrons. First of all, electron is removed from any material from the valence shell. In case of sodium, what is the valence shell? In case of sodium, valence shell is 3s. So, first of all, electron from sodium is removed from 3s. After 3s, electron will be removed from 2p and we will keep on removing electron from 2p until and unless 2p becomes empty, because there are 6 electrons. So one electron is removed from 3s and followed by 3s, 6 electrons, they will be removed from 2p. Once all the electrons from 2p have been removed, then electrons from 2s will be removed. And finally, electrons from 1s, they can be removed if enough amount of energy is available. Now, one thing you must remember, ionization energy is always endothermic. It is always endothermic. Energy is always absorbed whenever an electron is removed. Why energy is always absorbed? Because we break a bond, we break a force. What is the name of the force that is broken whenever an electron is removed from a material? The force is known as electrostatic force of attraction. So we will have to break electrostatic force of attraction during the removal of any electron. So always remember, ionization energy is endothermic. Second thing, whenever we remove first electron from the valence shell, that ionization energy is known as first ionization energy. And likewise, when we keep on losing electron, ionization energy, it becomes second, third, and so on. Like in this case, for sodium, we can have how many ionization energy values? We can have 11 ionization energy value. Since removal of electron, it always takes place from the valence shell towards the shell that is closest to the nucleus. So it means removal of each successive electron, it is becoming difficult and difficult. So ionization energy, each successive ionization energy, it would become more and more endothermic. So least endothermic ionization energy would be first ionization energy that is needed for the removal of 3s electron. And most endothermic ionization energy in case of sodium, it would be for 11th electron, 11th ionization energy, when electron will be removed from 1s subshell. that is closest to the nucleus. Now, what is the sequence that I have told you for the removal of these electron? We can make a table and you can see the sequence of removal of electron. Now, electron number 1 we will remove from which subshell? It will be removed from 3s. After 3s, now next electron, it will be removed from electron number 2p. But since there are 6 electrons, so from electron number 2 to 7, these 6 electrons, they will be removed from subshell 2p. Once 2p will become empty, and if we provide more energy, electron number 8 and 9, they would be removed from subshell 2s. And finally, the last 2 electrons, electron number 10 and 11, they will be removed from subshell 1s. And these 2 electrons, they are most difficult to be removed. Electron from 1s, they are most difficult to be removed because they are closest to the nucleus of sodium atom. Okay. Now, what you must remember, whenever we consider all the ionization energies for a given element, always remember all the ionization energies for a given element can be divided into 3 types. There can be 3 different types of changes in the ionization energy values for a given element. Now, what can be these 3 types of energy changes in the ionization energy values? One type of change, always you will notice in the ionization energy values of different elements, it can be known as sudden increase, sudden change in ionization energy. This is one type of change that we can notice during the removal of electron from a single element. Second type of change that we can notice, it is slight change or slight increase. And the third type of change that can be observed, it is known as steady increase in ionization energy values or steady change. So always remember, whenever you have been given ionization energy values for a single element, in a single element, there can be 3 different types of changes that can be noticed. Sudden change, slight change, steady change. Now, what is the reason? Why there is sudden change? Why there is slight change? Why there is steady change? I will explain it, all this information to you people. But before that, let's sketch a graph for these 11 ionization energy values of sodium with respect to each electron removed. So whenever a graph is sketched, on the y-axis, we always have ionization energy values. On the x-axis, we have total number of electrons removed. Right now, we are removing 11 electrons, and electron number 1 will be removed first of all, and electron number 11 will be removed at the end. So, the removal of electron would have this sequence: electron number 1 first of all, and electron number 11 at the end. So, the ionization energy that is needed to remove first electron from 3s, as I told you, this would be least endothermic. This would have minimum magnitude of ionization energy value. So this can be the ionization energy value for the removal of first electron. When we will remove second electron, this will be the ionization energy value for third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. These are the electrons that were removed from 2p. Followed by 2p, electron number 8 and 9, as you can see, they are removed from 2s. And finally, electron number 10 and 11, they have been removed from subshell 1s. Now you can join all these points to get a proper shape of the graph. Now you can see, this is the shape of the graph when ionization energy values are sketched or plotted against number of electrons removed for a given element. Now in this case, you can notice different types of energy change. How you can label these type of energy change as sudden change, slight change, or steady change? Look at this. look at this change that I am highlighting. This is the change from electron number 1 to 2. What you can guess? This is which type of change? Yes, you are right. This type of change is known as sudden change. This is sudden change. Now, what is the reason behind that? Let's see. Look, first electron, it was removed from 3s. 3s belongs to shell number 3, the valence shell. After electron number 1, electron number 2, it was removed from 2p. 2p, it belongs to shell number 2. So what does this mean? What has happened moving from electron number 1 to electron number 2? Which type of change it is noticed? Sudden change. Why sudden change? Because what has happened within the atom? What has happened within the shell? There is a change in the shell number. From first shell, first electron, it was removed from 3s. But the second electron, it is removed from shell number 2. So always remember, whenever there is a sudden change indicates change of shell. Likewise, you will notice another sudden change when electron number 10 will be removed. Why? Because electron number 10 and 11, they have been removed from 1s. And 1s, it is the last shell present around the nucleus. Last shell as we are moving inwards. First shell, I am considering third shell, second shell, and then the first shell. So what does this mean? Since there are three shells in an atom of sodium, so how many sudden changes we can notice? Two. So likewise, if an element would have four shells, how many sudden changes we can notice? Three, and so on. So right now, what information you must remember? Whenever, wherever you see a sudden change, sudden increase, it means there is a change of shell. That is the simple explanation. You must remember that whenever new electron is removed from a completely filled stable shell, there is always a greater change, a sudden change in the ionization energy value. Likewise, let's move on. And what you can see from electron number 2 to electron number 7, what name we can give to this type of change in the ionization energy values? Yes. This type of change, it is known as steady change. This is steady change. Why steady change? You can guess quite easily now. I have given you an idea for the reason behind sudden change. Now it has become obvious why in this case steady change can be noticed. Since electrons are removed from orbitals of the same subshell, whenever there is steady change in ionization energy, it means electrons are removed from orbitals of same subshell. No change in shell, no change in subshell. Only orbitals are changed. Then there is steady change. Compared to this, if we move on from electron number 7 to electron number 8, when we will remove electron number 8, you can see electron number 8 is removed from subshell 2s. Is there a change of shell? No. There is a change of subshell, because electron number 7, it was removed from 2p, but electron number 8, it has been removed from 2s. So this type of change, it is known as slight change. What does slight change mean? Change of subshell within a shell. So this is the description that you must remember for sudden change. Simply remember, sudden change means change of shell. Slight change means change of subshell. And steady change means change of orbitals within a shell. So change of shell, change of subshell, change of orbitals. Now likewise, now it has become quite obvious. You can label the remaining part of this graph. You can see this portion. It is the second sudden change when electron number 10 will be removed from shell number 1. While electron number 9, it was removed from shell number 2. So that is why again a sudden change is noticed. While this change, it is steady, because electron number 8 and 9, they were removed from orbital of the same subshell. Likewise, steady change you can notice for the removal of electron number 10 and 11. Since electron number 10 and 11, they are removed from orbitals of subshell 1s. So this is the description that you must remember. And again, I am telling you, whenever you have been given this type of graph for one element, for a single element, we can notice, we can observe three types of changes in the energy values of ionization energy. So why these three changes? What they represent? Just remember, sudden change means change of shell, slight change means change of subshell, steady change means change of orbitals within a subshell. Now, one last information that is even more important than these three type of changes. And this information, now that I'm going to tell you, this information is the basis of all the questions that are asked in your exams. Now, what is that important piece of information? In the exams, always remember, you will have to focus first sudden change. First sudden change, it is most important for us in deciding so much information about that element. Why? Look at this. Always remember, number of electrons removed before first, this is the first sudden change that I have highlighted. This is the first sudden change. Remember, number of electrons removed before first sudden change, it is always equal to valence electrons. Number of electrons removed before first sudden change, it is always equal to valence electrons. And it is always equal to group number of an element. So right now, what you can see, how after how many electrons first sudden change has taken place, you can see after the removal of one electron, after the removal of one electron, sudden change is observed. So what does this mean? This element, it has how many valence electrons? It has one valence electron, and that is true. And this valence number of electron tells us the group number of sodium, and the group number of sodium is 1. That is also true. So remember, this is the most important piece of information. Whenever you are given ionization energy values or this type of graph, you must remember that number of electrons removed before first sudden change. That is the most important piece of information for answering different types of question. Why? Number of electron removed before first sudden change, it is always equal to valence electron. It is always equal to group number. Now, what type of questions can be asked based on this information? Let's solve some questions. First question I will solve for you people, and the remaining question you can solve yourself. Okay, let's solve a question related to this information. Again, I'm telling you, the second piece of information that is most important, you will have to keep this information in your mind while answering this question. Okay, the question can be given like this. Instead of a graph, you may be given first few ionization energy values for an element. Element is X in this case, and the first few ionization energy values are given to you. Okay, now what you will have to do? You will have to find from the given ionization energy values where there is first sudden change. Where there is first sudden change. You can find this by simply looking at the given numerical values. But if you think this is difficult, you can use a calculator to get a difference between two successive ionization energy values, and then you can notice where there is first sudden change, first sudden increase in the ionization energy values. Okay, right now, let's use the calculator, get the difference between two successive ionization energies, and then we will decide where there is the sudden change. How to get the difference? Second ionization energy is 1930 minus first ionization energy. What is the difference? The difference is 1352. दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द आयोनाइजेशन एनर्जी नंबर वन एंड सेकेंड आयोनाइजेशन एनर्जी. लाइकवाइज डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेकेंड एंड थर्ड 2780 माइनस 1930. सो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेकेंड एंड थर्ड आयोनाइजेशन एनर्जी वैल्यू इट इज 850. दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेकेंड एंड थर्ड. नाउ थर्ड एंड फोर्थ आयोनाइजेशन एनर्जी द डिफरेंस विल बी 9200 माइनस 2780. द डिफरेंस इज 6420. दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन थर्ड एंड फोर्थ. लाइकवाइज फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ 11280 माइनस 9200. द डिफरेंस इज 2080. सो लाइकवाइज यू कैन फाइंड डिफरेंस फॉर ऑल द गिवन आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी. दिस इज 2080 एंड द लास्ट वन 14500 माइनस 11280. द डिफरेंस इज 14500 माइनस 11280. द डिफरेंस इज 3220. ओके नाउ लुक एट द डिफरेंस एंड आइडेंटिफाई वेयर देयर इज फर्स्ट सडन चेंज इन द आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी. एंड इट इज वेरी सिंपल. द फर्स्ट सडन आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी चेंज इज 6420. व्हाट डज दिस मीन? बिफोर दिस फर्स्ट सडन चेंज हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हैव बीन रिमूव्ड? 1, 2, and 3. व्हाट डज दिस मीन? इट मीन्स व्हाट इज द ग्रुप नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट एक्स? इट मीन्स द ग्रुप नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट एक्स इज 3. Why the group number of element x is 3? Because there are valence and there are 3 valence electrons. How come there are 3 valence electrons? Because first sudden change has taken place after the removal of 3 electrons. So this is how you can get to know what is the number of valence electron, how to decide the group number. Second thing that can be asked, once you have come to know the group number, you can be asked to write down a formula for either compound of that element. Right now you can be asked to write down a formula for the oxide of element X or for the chloride of element X. Now once we have identified the group number, from the group number we can find the valency. Valency is always equal to number of unpaired electron. So X belongs to group number 3. How many electrons we are having in the valence shell? 3. If we distribute 3 electrons, what you can see, how many unpaired electron it has? It has 3 unpaired electron. So the valency of X is 3. Oxygen, we want to make the formula of oxide of element X. Oxygen belongs to group number 6. So how many valence electron it has? It has 6 valence electron. If we distribute electrons of oxygen 6, we will get 2 unpaired. So what does this mean? Valency of X is 3 while the valency of oxygen is 2. Just cross multiply these two valencies, you will get the formula of oxide of element X, X2O3. And the formula of chloride of element X will be X, its valency is 3, chlorine belongs to group number 7. Its valency is 1. So the formula will be XCl3. So this is how you can find formula of any given compound for a given element, depending on the group number, depending on the ionization energy values. One more thing that can be asked, to write down valence shell electronic configuration for this element. For this element X, we have come to know there are how many valence electron. There are 3 valence electrons. Every shell starts from which subshell? Every shell starts from subshell S. So first of all, we will fill electrons into S, followed by S. If we have more electrons, the other electrons, they will be added into subshell P. So right now व्हाट विल बी द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन फॉर द वैलेंस शेल? वैलेंस शेल इज हैविंग 3 इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो यू कैन राइट डाउन एस 2, एंड हाउ मेनी इलेक्ट्रॉन्स लेफ्ट फॉर पी 1, एंड वी डोंट नो व्हाट इज द वैलेंस शेल नंबर. व्हेन एवर वी डोंट नो द वैलेंस शेल नंबर, वी कैन राइट डाउन प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर एन. सो दिस इज एक्सेप्टेबल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन इफ यू राइट डाउन इन टर्म्स ऑफ एन, बिकॉज फ्रॉम द वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन वी कैन नॉट प्रिडिक्ट वैलेंस शेल नंबर. सो वी हैव रिटन एन, एन कैन हैव एनी वैल्यू, एन कैन हैव एनी वैल्यू ईदर 2 और ग्रेटर देन 2. ओके, सो दीज आर द 3 टिपिकल टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन फर्स्ट सडन चेंज इन आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी कैन बी आस्क्ड. आई एम गिविंग यू अ क्वेश्चन, यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो, यू कैन सॉल्व दैट क्वेश्चन एंड देन आई विल गिव यू द आंसर टू दैट क्वेश्चन. द क्वेश्चन इज फर्स्ट फ्यू आयनाइजेशन एनर्जी फॉर एलिमेंट एम आर गिवन इन किलो जूल पर मोल. बाई यूजिंग अ कैलकुलेटर यू कैन गेट द डिफरेंस. इवन विदाउट यूजिंग अ कैलकुलेटर, इफ यू आर स्ट्रॉन्ग इन मेंटल मैथ, यू कैन गेट वेयर देयर इज फर्स्ट सडन चेंज. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू हैव अटेम्प्टेड दिस क्वेश्चन, लेट्स लुक एट वेयर देयर इज फर्स्ट सडन चेंज. फर्स्ट सडन चेंज इट कैन बी नोटिस्ड आफ्टर द रिमूवल ऑफ 4 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट सडन चेंज. सो वट डज दिस मीन? वट इज द ग्रुप नंबर ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट? द ग्रुप नंबर ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट इज 4. Why? Because its valence shell has 4 electrons. Since first sudden change has taken place after the removal of 4 electrons. What can be the formula of oxide? Oxygen has a valency of 2. This element M has a valency of 4. Whenever we can simplify, we could simplify valencies, we simplify. Now one is having a valency of 4, other 2. If we take 2 common, so the valency will be 1:2. So the formula will be MO2. MO2 is the formula of the oxide. And what will be the formula for the chloride of element M? MCl4, because Cl has a valency of 1. And now the electronic configuration for the valence shell of element M, NS2, NP2, because there are 4 electrons. So 4 electrons, 2 electrons in subshell S, 2 electrons in subshell P. Okay, one more question quickly. This is an MCQ question. Based on this information, just try to get the answer. This time you have been given element X. First few ionization energy values of element X are given, and you have been given 4 options. Pick the correct option. What is the correct formula for the oxides, for the chlorides of element X? What is the correct formula for the chlorides of element X? Yes. Okay, students, if you have attempted, you can see where there is first sudden change. First sudden change, it can be noticed after the removal of 5 electrons here. So what does this mean? It means element X belongs to group number 5. If we distribute 5 electrons, what we will come to know? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It means there are 3 unpaired electrons. So the valency of X is 3. So what will be the correct formula? Yes, you are right. The correct formula will be XCl3. XCl3. Okay students, I hope you would have enjoyed this lecture. Now these are very important questions commonly asked in your papers. So you can watch this lecture again just to make your concept more clear. If you have any question related to this lecture, please give your feedback in the comments. Thank you very much.